Hello, here's Michael Albers from Germany with a video tutorial about Anime CC 2017 with some new features in HTML5 Canvas. We have some new components and the video component for HTML5 Canvas, and I will show you how to use it. And now we start. I make a new HTML5 Canvas document and I save it. So now I go to Window, Components, and here we have this video component. I drag it to the stage, and now in the Property Inspector I can choose the source of the video. I click on this icon and I choose my video. Okay. Here we have automatic playing, and here we have the buttons for stopping, playing, mute, and so on. That's all we need to do. Now I test this thing. And now we have here the video, and we can stop it at the bottom. Okay, so far so good. Now I want to make something different. I want to stop and play the video with my own buttons. So I deactivate the things here and I put some buttons on the stage. One button for stopping and one button for playing. Now everything needs an instance name. I call this playing button play underscore btn. This one gets a name stop underscore btn, and the video gets a name frog. So for the JavaScript I can use code fragments. I go to Window, Actions, and now we have here the code fragments, HTML5 Canvas, and here we have components, video, playing video, stopping video, mute video, loading video, and so on. But first I must click on the video, and then I double click play video. Then again I click on the video and I double click on stop video. Now we need event listeners for the button. I click on the play button and I go to events and I double click mouse click event, and the rest I make by myself. So we have the JavaScript for playing the video, and here's the JavaScript for stopping it. Here is our mouse click event, here is our function, and here the function is defined. So all I have to do is to put this line in this function. The name of the function is not very good. I call this function play video. So now we need the same thing for the other button. I copy the whole thing here. The button is called stop. I call the function stop video. And the JavaScript is pause. So that's it. It is important to deactivate this automatic playing because I want to play it with the button. Now I test it. My video doesn't start. Now I start it and now I stop it. Very well. So now I want to make something different. I want to stop the video at a certain time. And here I can use a property, a video property, called current time. This property gives me the seconds the video has played. So I can set this property and I can read it. And when in an if structure, I can ask if this current time is bigger than 5 or whatever, and then I stop the video. So I make the function, I call this stop video again. And here I make an if structure, if, and in the if structure I ask, if current time is bigger than 4 seconds. And in that case, the video should stop. Now I need an event listener for this function. And this event listener must go in a loop. I can use the tick event, but I can use also a time update event. Time update event is a video event. And I use this event. And I put the event listener into this play video function. So when the video plays, the event listener starts. The event is time update, and this will call the stop video function, which I defined here. So let's take a look if this works. I start the video, video plays, and after some time it stops. I can use this current time property also to play a video at a certain time. I can set this property. And if I set this current time, and after I play the video, the video starts at second 25. So let's take a look. Yeah, we can see the video starts later. So another situation, if you want to show something above the video, it's not really possible. The video lies above all the other content in the canvas element. But you can make the video invisible with JavaScript style sheet, and this goes like this: style, then the CSS property, and then the value. And when you want to show the video again, you use the value block, display block. So now, after 4 seconds, the video must be invisible. So let's take a look. I start it. Now it plays 5 seconds and the video is invisible. So that's it for this video tutorial. I hope you enjoy it. If you like it, you can give me a thumb. You are Michael Albers from Germany.